Now, anytime you want to stretch one portion of an image independently of another, you need to work with a rectangular selection outline that you create using the Rectangular Marquee tool. And that's because that way you select entire rows or columns of pixels at a time. All right, now I'm going to draw a selection that goes almost to the top of the rocks right here on the left-hand side and all the way down to the transparent region below the photograph. And so I want you to see here that I am very close. The top of the selection is very close to the bottom corner of this rock formation right here. I want to make sure that I include this entire thing, this weed, but I don't include any of the foliage in the background. All right, now I'll press Control-0 or Command-0 on the Mac to zoom out. I do not want to stretch the boy's legs, so I'm going to deselect them again using the Rectangular Marquee tool by pressing and holding the Alt key, so I get a minus sign next to my cursor, and then I will deselect from over to the left of Sam's wristband down to the right of Max's toe. And I'll end up with this effect here. So I have two rectangular regions of rock selected. I don't want to harm the original image, so I'll jump this selection to a new layer by pressing Control-Alt-J or Command-Option-J on the Mac, and I'll just go ahead and call this layer Stretch, and then click OK. All right, now I need to be able to scroll downward a little bit like so, and I'm doing so just using the scroll wheel on my mouse. If you can't get that to work, then press Control-K or Command-K on the Mac to bring up the Preferences dialog box, switch to Tools, and then go ahead and turn on this guy, Over Scroll. And it allows you to scroll any which way you like, regardless of the zoom ratio. At which point, go ahead and click OK. All right, now I could go ahead and stretch this layer using the standard Free Transform command located under the Edit menu. In which case, I would go ahead and drag this bottom handle. Unfortunately, that scales the image proportionally. So as I drag, I'll go ahead and press and hold the Shift key like so. And then I'll drag downward until my height value comes very close to 150%. So notice the width value is 100%, which is to say we're scaling the layer exclusively vertically, at which point I'll press the Enter key or the Return key on the Mac to accept that change. And then I'll zoom in on these rocks. And you can see here that they are exclusively stretched, so they are now much taller than they are wide, on a uniform basis, by the way. So every rock is stretched, and we have this very pronounced seam right here between the unstretched pixels and the stretched ones. And that seam appears over here to the left of Sam as well. Notice his rock doesn't look right at all. All right, so I'll go ahead and press Control-Z or Command-Z on the Mac to undo that change, and I'll go ahead and zoom out once again and scroll down as well. And this time, instead of using Free Transform, I'm going to take advantage of this command, Content Aware Scale, which will allow us to stretch the layer while introducing a little bit of AI. In other words, Photoshop is going to automatically decide which details it scales on the fly. And so I'll go ahead and choose that command. And again, if I just drag down on this handle, I scale the image proportionally, which doesn't even make sense. It defies the purpose of this command in the first place. But at any rate, I'll go ahead and press and hold the Shift key as I drag this guy down. And I will once again drag that handle down until I have a height value of more or less 150%. At which point, I'll press the Enter key or the Return key on the Mac to accept that change. And now I want you to see what we've got. Not all of the rocks are scaled to 150%. Some are scaled much less, and some are scaled even more. And as a result, we have this kind of molten effect where we have these wave patterns in the rocks, which obviously is not acceptable. So I'm going to press Control-Z or Command-Z on the Mac to undo that change. And I'll go ahead and zoom out a little bit. And I'll return to the Edit menu and once again choose Content Aware Scale. And I want you to notice a couple of options over here. We've got this guy. Its job is to protect skin tones. You can experiment with it if you want. Doesn't work very well. Then we have this protect option, which is going to seem mystifying because it's just going to read none. For it to read anything else, you would need an alpha channel. So an additional channel in the channels panel, which would then protect certain details inside the image. We don't need that, however. We do need this guy right here, the amount value, which is going to allow us to minimize some of the distortion. So what I'll do is I'll go ahead and drag this handle down right here, the bottom middle handle, that is to say, while pressing the Shift key, So I go ahead and expand this guy so that the height value is once again in the neighborhood of 150%. And now you can see, once again, we have that kind of flowing effect there, those wavy rocks, at which point I'll go ahead and reduce the amount value, and notice that that brings back some of the structure. So if I crank it all the way down to 0%, it's the same as if I was using the free transform command. We're not introducing any AI at all, which is why I'll go ahead and take it up a little bit, but even at 20%, we end up getting some waves. And so I ended up coming up with a value of 12%, which I found just by pressing the up and down arrow keys until I got something I liked, at which point I'll press the Enter key or the Return key on the Mac a couple of times to accept that change. All right, now, because we reduced that value, we're going to get some seams. And so what you want to do is select the Spot Healing Brush tool, which has a keyboard shortcut of J, and then go up to the Options bar and turn on Sample All Layers. And then I'm going to press the right bracket key a few times in order to expand the size of my cursor. And I'll just go ahead and paint back and forth up along this line like so. And that should help to get rid of that seam. All right, we need to do the same thing over here on the left side of Sam. Starting right about there is where I'm seeing the seam. And then just painting down. And what we're looking for, where the transition between the tiny rocks and the big rocks is concerned, we want the little rocks to look like they're overlapping onto the big ones. That's going to make the most visual sense anyway. And then I'll go ahead and paint down like so. And if you paint out into this region, it's entirely fine. All right, now I'll press Control-0 or Command-0 on the Mac in order to center my zoom. And I'll press the M key to switch back to my rectangular marquee tool. And that's how you stretch an image detail while adding a little bit of AI to the equation using the Content-Aware Scale command.